Good morning. And so we're going to talk about the trailer exposure study in the Great Lake Tributary. And the big idea is to try to understand how the CECs in the wild impact on the reproductive health or the long-term health on the population level, but using the click.
Oh.
This, okay. So using the, we used this mobile exposure lab trailer. So the, we have the, this tank set up in the trailer, and we did the exposure to fathead minnow, 21 days exposure, and 50% static renewal, and we look at the different endpoint. And one major thing we're gonna show today is the fecundity, how many egg was laid on the their nest, and we also measured the vitrogen and the glucose and estrogen and testosterone and body condition factor and other stuff. But today we're going to focus on the fecundity. And we did this study in four different locations. And in 2016 and 2017, we did the exposure in Maumee area. And we had the seven different locations here, and the from upstream to downstream. And we collected water from there the every other day and expose fish in the trailer. And fathead minnow is the paired fathead minnow, and this each tank had the pair of the fathead minnow. So firstly, gonna show you the how many chemical we detect in those surface water. And this is showing the two different year, 2016 and 2017. And you can see the some difference. And the 2016 in general, the pharmaceutical was the dominant. And 2017, the pesticide was dominant in just general. So we'd like to know how those impact on the reproduction in fathead minnow. And this showing the fecundity, so how many egg was found on their nest during the 21 days exposure. And the blank is the control. The blank is the double filtered city water. And so compared to the blank, PBG and GRM and BCR was higher. And in 2016 and 2017, the most of sites show the increase the fecundity in the exposure to this water from this site. So the clearly the exposure has changed the fecundity, but how that happened and the this fecundity change was not simply correlate with the contaminant concentration. So we're gonna look at the we look at the estrogenicity of the each mixture or the each surface water. We developed the species specific estrogen receptor transactivation assay. So this is showing the how the environmental surface water stimulating the estrogen receptor from three different species. We use the fathead minnow and bluegill sunfish and largemouth bass. And you can see this in pink, it's the largemouth bass estrogen receptor. But it's the bluegill estrogen receptor looks like more sensitive to the environmental signal than other species. And in Maumee, 2016 showed the decrease of the estrogen receptor activity in BCR and PBG and UCR, these three sites. And Maumee 2017 showed that GRM has decreased. So GRM was the one of the interesting patterns showing in here. So fecundity, GRM was high in 2016, and both are high in 2017, 2016. And GRM showing the some difference in the in vitro result in 2017. So the estrogenicity was not simply correlated. So we need to look at the more detail how those fecundity difference is induced. And fecundity difference was not associated with the vitrogenin production either. So we need to look at the more detail. And we also did the same experiment in the Maumee in 2017 and 2018. So this is showing the site in the Maumee. And the contaminant in CC contaminant in the Maumee, Milwaukee area, sorry, it's Milwaukee area, was unique. And MEF site has the pharmaceutical, mostly pharmaceutical, and other site is contaminated with the other CECs other than pesticide and pharmaceutical and hormones. And same thing that we did this 21 days exposure to the fathead minnow pair. And fecundity show the control group is here. And 2017-2018 control showing in blue, and mostly the increased fecundity. And the MIE and UCR and MIP, MEF, and mostly all of them are higher than control. So the contamination and the fecundity is not simply associated either in the Milwaukee area. And we also look at the estrogenicity through the receptor in vitro. And again, the bluegill estrogen receptor has shown the some significant change increase in 2017, and the same increase here in 2018. But again, this was not simply correlate or associate with the fecundity data. But so based on these 3 years data, we try to estimate or predict where's the vulnerable location. And we select the two location in 2019 and Two River and Grand Rapid. And we did the same experiment, 21 days fathead minnow exposure in trailer. And Two River site, the one site ETR showing the extremely high concentration of the pharmaceutical, And ground rapid, the generally the old site was the similar, and PCR site was a little lower contaminant detected. And here's the fecundity and the control group showing here and blank here. So in two liver, the MAR was high, and this other site also showed the high production of the spawning egg. And in ground rabbit, IDW and UTA was showing the difference in fecundity. And we measure the estrogenicity in vitro through the fathead minnow and bluegill and largemouth bass estrogen receptor. And the one site ETR showed the increased estrogenicity, and the REF site showed the decreased estrogenicity, but not simply correlate with the contaminant data or fecundity data. And in ground rapid, the two sites show the decrease and increase the fecundity, like this IDW and UTA. But it's not simply IDW and UTA. It's not simply associated with the fecundity change. Also, that we see the sum of the reduction in the estrogenicity in the in vitro exposure.
So Satomi, you have about 3 minutes remaining.
Okay, thank you. So as conclusion, it's not conclusive result. So we still working on the understand the result, and we need the further investigation, and we will find out which chemical will be the key for fecundity and which area will be vulnerable in the future. And I'd like to thank for the Great Lake Restoration Initiative and Fish and Wildlife Service for funding support. Thank you. I can take any question.
Great, thank you, Satomi. We do have time for a couple of questions, about 2 minutes remaining.
No questions so far.
I have a question, Satomi, while we're waiting to see if others do. So yep. Looking at your the fecundity graphs, so based yes. on sort of where things fall, sort of some in any of them work. So any where I see sort of the blank sort of falling in the middle, it looks like some sites have lower the fatheads have lower fecundity, some sites they have higher fecundity. In terms of impacts to the species, is one of those better or worse, you know, for the minnows themselves? Are they both detrimental or neither detrimental?
If the fecundity decrease, it's clearly not great.
Right, right.
And increase, I don't know. Might be better, or they might be stimulate the reproduction, but the same time that we don't know this, the sex will be, the sex ratio will be screwed up or not. So that part we don't know. So that part, I'm interested in the sex determination part. So that might be the contaminant impact on the sex ratio. If so, the offspring number is increased, that might be not great.
And you'd have to do like generational studies to figure that out, right?
Yes, we did. Okay. Either of, yes.
Thanks.
Thank you.